Assalamualaikum dear students, welcome to class 5 part 2 continuation of the lesson interdependence. Yes. Now we know that we all are interdepending on each other. Okay. Now farmers will cultivate the crops, so they are called as the producers. Okay. For example, if the farmer is producing wheat and he will sell it and the wheat flour is made in the mill and then it is being supplied in the stores. And we become the consumer because we buy it and we consume this product. Okay, so we consume the product and we use it for our eating purpose. So we depend on these people, that is the farmers, for the things, and they depend on us for their livelihood. Why they are depending? How are they depending? Because we in return give them money and they are in return giving us the food products. Okay, so we are interdepending on each other. Yes, here can you see this person? Who is he? He is Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Okay, he is a scientist. Now, Dr. M.S. Swaminathan is known as the father of Green Revolution in India. So, who is called the father of Green Revolution in India? It is Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. Now, you should know, what is Green Revolution? Okay, Green Revolution was started by this doctor, okay, in the year 1960s. The Green Revolution took place in India, which changed the status of India from a food deficient country to a self-sufficient country in terms of food. Okay, now what is done in this Green Revolution? They have introduced modern methods, okay, including high yielding of variety. Okay, high yielding of variety seeds. Because if you put good quality of seeds in the soil, what happens is you get a very good yield. Okay, you get a very good crop. So, that is called high yielding variety seeds. And machines were introduced such as tractors. Yes, machines were introduced such as tractors in agriculture. Better irrigation facility. Irrigation means good supply of water. And use of fertilizers and pesticides. Use of good fertilizers and pesticides. Can you see here a person is spraying the pesticides or the fertilizers in the field? Why? Because these pesticides will prevent the rats and all the pests to enter into the fields and destroy them. Okay, so they will sprinkle the pesticides, and fertilizers will give good strength to the soil. Okay, so that is called as fertilizer and pesticide. So did you understand the difference? Fertilizer means it will give the strength to the soil, and pesticide means it is a poison which will kill the animals, which will enter the fields and destroy the crops. Okay, now this Green Revolution began in Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. Okay, and later it spread to all other states of India. It increased the agricultural production manifold. Next we will talk about interdependence of government and people. Now how is government interdepending on people? Okay, how are we both interdependent? The government takes care of our need in many ways. It gives us public services such as parks, sports complexes, transport such as buses, metros and trains, schools, hospitals and water. It takes care of law and order through police forces, and even they are using the armed forces. Now how are we depending? Now the government is giving us all these things. Yes, but in return, what is the government getting from us? We are paying taxes to the government. Okay, now after taking the money from us, taxes from us, the income tax, road tax, yes, and then we are paying the service taxes whenever we are buying the goods, yes, then whenever we buy gold also we are paying taxes. So with these taxes, the government will, you know, they will give us all this supplies of transport, yes, all the public services, like we are having government hospitals, they do all the maintenance, and also they give salary to the government employees like to the police and armed forces. So in this way the government and the people are interdependent. Interdependence between countries. Countries too depend on each other for their needs. The goods that are produced in surplus, that is in more amount by a country, are exported to other countries. Exported means sending it from here to other countries. A country may not have certain things, which is imports from other countries. Okay, that is, like for example, India exports spices because spices are more in India. Spices such as cardamom and pepper to other countries like Saudi Arabia or any other country, okay, which does not have spices. Now in return, what India does it, we do not have more of petroleum. So we buy petroleum from the other countries. So taking in things from other countries is known as import, okay. Export means we are sending from our country to another, we are selling it. Import means we are bringing it from the other country to our country. So for example, spices we give to other country, we export it, and we import in return petroleum from Arab countries, okay. So this buying, selling and exchange of things between people or countries is called trade. What is trade? Buying, selling and exchange of things between people or countries is called as trade. So now you have come to know that everybody is depending on each other. Even by nature, human beings, animals depend on plants for air, that is oxygen and carbon dioxide. Even producers and consumer, we depend on each other. Farmer and consumer is us. Okay, we depend. Then interdependence between the countries for import and export purposes. And also the government is depending upon the people, and people in turn are depending on the government for the needs. Okay, so we complete this chapter. Now exercise A, B to be completed in the textbook, and exercise C and D to be done in the classwork. Refer page 6.